Hey guys, it's coffee time with Cobra. And you know what, I'm not sure if it's a Fett day or if it's a Han day, but either way, Star Wars is life. Well, plain and simple. Being the son of a stormtrooper, you know what I mean? So, yesterday, I was asked during my live stream, how do I handle cheating on my diet and things like that and whatnot, because you guys know I am dieting, and I have gone down from a size 42, 44 inch waist to a 36. Everyone wants to know what my secret is. Okay, it's no secret. Five small meals, two protein based, so chicken or fish. So I eat basically five little salads. I set them up. I have little Tupperware containers. Mostly bulked out with cucumbers and celery, with a little bit of lettuce, not much, shredded cabbage and carrot. So I'm getting my beta carotene, I'm getting my whatever, B vitamin. I take a B12 vitamin supplement as well, and cod liver oil. Take a little cod liver oil tablet with one aspirin. The aspirin is just basically a immune, I wouldn't say immune boost or anything. All it does is just help with things like joint inflammation, things like that happen throughout the day. Because I'm getting old, I do suffer from arthritis. I've got it in my elbows, and I have it in my my fingers. If you notice, my fingers aren't straight. That's because of arthritis. Literally, my if you look at my hands, okay, look how bent my wedding finger is. Okay, I literally have to turn it. Literally, look how far I have to turn it to make it look straight for you guys. It's literally that bent, and literally it overlaps my FU finger, okay, because of arthritis. It happens when you're in the military, where you're constantly using muscle memory to strut rifles, load guns, things like that. So it is what it is, guys. I ain't complaining about it. It's a family trait. My uncle had it. Both of my uncles had it on my mum's side. My dad started to get it in his age before he passed away, so you know, it is what it is, you know. It's a sign of old age, you know. Now I know why my dad was always a grumpy fucker, you know. But it's all it is. Oh, and exercise wise, core exercise and cardio, so treadmill, jogging, jumping jacks, you name it, just enough to get your heart pumping a little bit. I'm on a half acre of land, okay guys. Yes, I've been cleaning up some of the trees and whatnot off stream and stuff. So, you know, I'm on a half acre of land. So what I do, as you guys know, during my coffee times, when I let the dogs out and the first thing in the morning, I will walk around my property. I will check my fence line. I will check, you know, my property and make sure. And that's right there. It's another one you can do. If you really want to go extreme and start losing the weight even quicker than I did, okay, there's a maneuver you can do called planking. Okay, you lay down on the ground face first, and then you rest on your forearms. Okay, so it's kind of like a sit-up, but without using your arms, using your forearms. Okay, and then what you do is you push up. Okay, you push up, shoving your bum up in the air, basically. It's a yoga position. What it will do is it will start working your core, your gut, your abdomen, your I mean, literally, it feels like your entire belly is on fire because your entire body weight is literally being pushed up by your gut, basically. And that's where the majority of your body fat is, 90% of human beings. It's in the belly. So what you're doing is you're causing those muscles to start eating your body fat, which it's already doing because you've already hyperly accelerated your metabolism by having your five meals. So basically, I've supercharged my metabolism. Also, what you can do to kickstart your metabolism, if you've got a really slow metabolism, is there's a thing you can do doctor friend of mine. What's up, bro?
Not much.
That a doctor friend of mine said you can take water and add a little bit of cayenne pepper into it and just drink it straight. Yeah, it's gonna burn when you pee, but the cayenne pepper will kick your metabolism in and start it to accelerate and stuff like that. Basically, it's like kicking your old Chevy truck in the ass to get it go down the hill. So yeah, pretty much that's what I do. So five small meals, two protein based, so chicken or fish. Cut out mostly a lot of pork and a lot of red meat, sadly. And I love my bacon. I love my sausage. I love my pork. And don't bother calorie counting. See, this is the thing. A lot of people do this whole freaking, okay, I'm only allowed to eat 1,800 calories a day. Okay. You want to know why those diets always fucking fail? And I mean always fail. You've got a 90% chance. It's got a 90% failure rate. You want to know why? Because you look at stuff and realize, okay, this jelly donut is 300 calories. This Kit Kat Chunky is 200 calories and stuff like that. And then you scrub those off a list of what you can eat and what you can't eat. Before you fucking know it, your brain's going, I want a Kit Kat Chunky donut. I want a Kit Kat Chunky donut, which they don't exist. I've already asked. You know, I want a Kit Kat.
Voodoo Donuts in Portland, Oregon sells them. And they just opened a Voodoo Donuts down in Vegas.
Well, looks like I'm going to Vegas then. But you see what I'm saying, guys? Stop. Don't have a list of things you can eat and things you can't, okay? Just have a list of things that say, okay, if I eat a Kit Kat Chunky, I've got to do 10 extra jumping jacks. Or I've got to do, you know, I've got to walk an extra 2 or 3 blocks, you know? Compromise. That's the key, is compromise, okay? Don't say, no, I can't ever have this or that anymore, okay? Because that's going to make your body want it even more, okay? Think about it. You ask a little prissy Christian girl, you know, is she a slut in the bedroom? She's going to giggle and say, no, I'm a good Christian girl. Truth is, she's got more kinky shit in her fucking closet than 50 Shades of Grey, okay? Plain and fucking simple, alright? Seriously, I'm Catholic, and I'm telling you, half the Catholic girls I ever dated, they were more freaky in the sack than I was.
Half the Jehovah's Witness girls that I know were fucking freaks.
Like I said, the more righteous they are, the more slutty they want to be in the bedroom. Well, that's the thing. Consider your diet the same way. If you're one of these sort of people that go to the gym and it's like, oh, let me take a selfie. Oh, let me take a selfie. Fuck off. Go away. Die in a fire. Seriously. Okay? Every time I go to a gym, if I see a wall that has nothing but mirrors, I turn around and walk away. Okay? Because those sort of places are for posers. Okay? Those places are for people that just want to say, yeah, damn, I look good. Oh my God, I can't wait to fap to this tonight. Because trust me, he's got no social life and his dick's so goddamn small because he's taken so much steroids. You know,
he's got to use a pair of tweezers to fap.
He's got to use a fucking pair of tweezers, and the only people he can fuck is Asian girls because they're used to being let down. Oh, shots fired. But no, I'm serious, all right? Look, end of the day, guys, when it comes down to it, the reason why I have drastically chosen to lose the weight and whatnot is for my own health and that of my children. Okay, you got to understand, I lost my father when I was 10 years old. Okay, when I was 10 years old, I lost my father. Okay, I lost him because of his drinking, his smoking, and the fact that when he left the military, he just didn't bother keeping himself in shape. Okay, I mean, I'm not talking like he had a six pack, I'm talking about he had a double keg. Okay, it would take two of those fucking Budweiser Clydesdales to get him out of bed. You know what I mean? My dad let himself go. And he let himself go because of my mum. Okay? Again, my mum and I have no love, okay, for each other. You guys who are, if you've been following the nation for any amount of time, this bloody mount at the bottom is loose as fucking, it's pissing me off. I've got to get a finger in it. There we go. Gotta tighten that screw up, so screw you. There we go. It was driving me nuts, guys. I'm sorry. That's the OCD in me. Well, me and my mum have no love lost. And I have memories of my mum and dad getting into fights. And she would call him a fat slob and everything else. And she'd purposely bring him down. She wouldn't build him up. She'd bring him down. Guys, if you are dating someone who does that to you, who does nothing but bring you down, get out of there. Get out of that relationship. If you're the one bringing your partner down, fucking shame on you. Okay? You're supposed to be their rock. You're supposed to be their partner. You're supposed to be their Bonnie to their Clyde and vice versa. Okay? Be there for each other. Okay? Be her king, be his queen. Okay? Be there for each other. Don't tear each other down. Don't tear into each other. Okay? Don't let stupid things like money come in between you two. Okay? You want to know why? Think about it. When you first got together, did you have any money? No? So why are you letting it bother you now? When you first got together, okay? How your relationship starts, to me, is a big telltale sign of how your relationship's always going to be. So think about it. If you're a fuckboy, okay, and you broke up with one of their, broke up her relationship because you just would not stop, you know, dogging her and whatnot, guess what, mate? She's gonna dog on you. Think about it. If you're a fuckboy and she dumped her man for you, What makes you think she's not looking for another fuckboy? Exactly. And vice versa. If you're an epic thunder cunt and you've cheated on your man, what makes you think that next guy ain't gonna look at you and go, you're an epic thunder cunt, and dump your ass faster than a fat man falling on ice? So, life lessons with Cobra. Other than that, what else has been going on? I had an epic stream yesterday. Made a whole bunch of new subs. Got hosted by Waxy. Thank you, Waxy, for the host, man. Didn't have to. I know you didn't have to, but you're honest, you're genuine, and I love you, man. I got nothing but love. And I know I bitch and harp and say Cotton this and Waxy that and Attaway this. You know why I say that? Jealousy. There, I said it. Jealousy. I'm jealous. Okay, I'm jelly. I'm so jelly, look, I wobble. You know, give me some milk and cookies. You know?
Hand me the camera and you can twerk over there.
Mm-hmm. Trust me, I got enough junk in my trunk, I could twerk now. But at the end of the day, guys, I have nothing but mad respect to everyone who's made it. And I have even more respect for those up and coming. So you, Fighter Pilot, Warhammer 2020, all you guys that hang out on my stream, and I know you guys stream, okay? I know you guys stream. I know you guys only stream up on the weekends or whatever. You know what? I wish you nothing but the best, my friends. This git right here, okay? He's got a Twitch channel, and I wish him nothing but the best. Everyone, why does everyone assume that I hate people and I don't want people to succeed? Motherfuckers, go to my vlogs, go to my stream VODs, and take a look at how many charity streams I've done.
Hell, look how many videos he's got, the freaking tutorials on how to stream.
Exactly.
If he didn't want anybody to succeed, he would have never done that.
And that's my fucking point. I want everyone to succeed, okay? I want everyone to succeed. And a big shout out to Fud Cannon and Marcus Beffett and the subscriber button on my Twitch channel last night. You guys are fucking awesome. You guys, nothing but love for me, man. Nothing but love for you guys too. Seriously. Like I said, if you're new to Twitch, if you're new to YouTube, if you're new to whatever, and you want some help, you know, hit me up. You know, just go to any social media and type in Deceptive Cobras. DecepticeCobras. Deceptive Cobras. Yes, there's no second E in Deceptive. Why? That's just spelt wrong. No, it's deceptively deceptive. That's the idea. It's my motto for my whole entire thing. I'm deceptively deceptive. You know? Oh, you look like a complete cunt and a tool. Really? And clearly you haven't seen me with my pants down. Does this look like a mangina? No. It looks like a baby's arm holding an orange. You know? See, only I can do that. Only I can do that. And that's what I love about my stream. It's what I love about you all. I know this is going to be a long vlog, and you know what? I don't fucking care. If you guys want to watch this vlog, a whole vlog thing, good for you. If not, I ain't even mad. I'm Will Smith, I ain't even mad. Yeah. Like I said, that was the funniest thing. Yeah, the other day when someone came into my stream to troll me, and they did, they came in just to troll me, and they were like doing this whole, one guy was like, you're so attractive, I want to fap to you. I'm like, whatever gets your jollies off, mate. Yeah. Here, I'll even do a nice little porno face. Yeah. And the guy's like, ew. And I'm like, yeah. What, you want to see something better? Ready? That's what I look like when I orgasm. And I totally trolled him back, and the guy was like, ew, and he left, you know? Like I said, guys, I'm at the point in my life where I just don't fucking care anymore. Alright? You will reach that point when in your late 20s, early 30s, and I'm serious, every guy and every girl goes through it. It's like, your friends will call, it's like, hey, you want to go out tonight? It's Friday. And you're like, but I've got my onesie on, and I got my cocoa, and there's a marathon of Buffy the Vampire Slayer. No. Yeah? Or whatever, or Battlestar Galactica.
The last time I had somebody do that to me, I was like, motherfucker, are you crazy? There's a goddamn Who marathon on. Fuck you.
Like I said, you just reach the age where it's like, I don't want to go clubbing anymore. I don't want to do this. I don't want to do that. It's like when my friends back in England realise that I'm sincere about moving back to England, which I am, guys, and I'll get on that subject here in a few. They were like, oh, dude, I can't wait to go club. Now you see why I'm getting ready to leave. Anyway, they were like, can't wait to go clubbing with you and stuff, man. My exact answer to them was, dude, my idea of clubbing is going down the pub and going home at 10:30. Just so I can, you know, get to the fucking, get to the, Hey, sweetie.
Hi, just to let you know, Cruella DeVille will probably be down here.
Cruella, your mom?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I'm about to call her and ask her for money.
Okay.
Grab some paper towels.
Run.
I don't know, guys. Anyway, long story short, guys, I just want to get down in the fish and chip shop, get me some curry and chips, and go home and eat it, and probably watch Emmerdale Farm or some shit. Well, I don't really watch Emmerdale Farm, but my mum does. But point is, you know, that's what I want to do. I just want to enjoy my life. You know, I'm. And everyone's like, you sound like you're 70 and getting ready to retire. I'm like, I've been ready to retire since I was 29. What are you talking about? My body's already halfway there. You know? Anyway, guys. Yes. I am severely, like, damn near 99% contemplated going back to England. Because I found out I cannot finish my green card application form and stuff while here in the States. So I'm going to end up having to go back to merry old Blighty, back to England, and then doing the whole back and forth from the American consulate until I can get all my paperwork sorted out. Hello. It's the KK.
Hello.
Hello. She says hello. Anyway, guys, but like I said, that's what I'm going to be doing. Doing the whole back and forth thing. And then once it's done and dusted, I'll probably be somewhat back-ish here permanently about this time next year. Because they're saying it's going to take about a year, year and a half. So I'm not even mad. I'm not even worried. I get to go back to England for a bit, hang out with my daughter. It's all good. No, I won't be including my daughter in any of my vlogs, simply because you pervs. Looking at you, pandemics. Perv. But yeah, other than that, guys, I'm just chilling, enjoying life, and yeah, pretty much that's it. So, thanks for hanging out, and I'll see you in the next video, guys. Bye.
Good morning, Mythical America. It is Coffee Time with Cobra, and I want to say thank you. Today is March 17th. 2017, holy shit, 2017. You know, when I was younger, I honestly thought we'd have flying cars and teleportation and warp drive and be able to go to other planets by 2017. Truth is, technology-wise, we really haven't made that much in strive, and it's a shame. It really is. I'm a huge fan of NASA, the whole space program. Heck, I'm a huge fan of underwater research. You know, the whole explore the oceans and stuff like that. You know, we've explored more space than we ever have our own oceans. That's sad, you know. Like I said, it's not like we can't apply technologies from one to the other. Of course we can, you know. Today is my birthday, guys. I'm not going to tell you how old I am, but put it like this. I remember when dirt was new. Okay. This is my way of saying thank you to everyone who has taken the time to wish me a happy birthday. I have 25 plus of my friends right here. I just woke up, and right here, I'm totally blown away, and I am totally in shock at the amount of love and support that I'm getting from you guys. I mean, I'm getting family members that I haven't spoken to in years contacting me again and talking to me. Austin, brother, I love you to death, I really do. Thank you for the happy birthday. You too, Nicole. I hope you and you and Mike are happy. I miss talking to you guys. Mary, thank you. Thank you, darling. I know we don't talk that often, me and you, Mary, but I love your artwork, I really do, and if I had the money, I would buy one of your pieces. They are absolutely amazing. Guys, if you haven't ever seen this woman's artwork, you have to. Her name is Mary Cacciapella, if I'm pronouncing her last name correctly. She is an amazing artist. She really is. You've got to check out some of her stuff. That's Steve Neal. That's another friend of mine. He's a model, master model and prop builder.
Mary Cachapala. There you go. It's pronounced Cachapala. She has her own gallery called the Gallery Infinity right here. It really is such a nice place. They're in California, Ventura. So if you're ever in the Ventura, California area, you know, please, please, please go check out her stuff. She's an amazing artist, absolutely amazing, talented, skilled, you name it. She's absolutely breathtaking. Her artwork is amazing, it really is, guys. Like I said, if I had the money, I would have a piece of her art on my wall, happily. It's just amazing stuff. Dirk, dude, thank you so much, brother. Much love to you. Jakey, my nephew, I love you, son, I really do. My brother, Scott. Scott, I may not have known you long, brother. And you know what? I can't wait to get to know you more. I really can't. And the fact I've got an older brother, it just amazes me. I've always wanted to know what it's like to have an older brother. And because I've always been the middle brother, I've got a younger brother, and you know. Simon, Effin, dude, love you, man. Much love to you, man. Kenny, now, guys, let me give you a little backstory here. Kenny Cannon, okay. When I first met that guy, I met him at Games Workshop Studios, again, Games Workshop Plaza in London, okay. Yes, GW. It was just, and I overheard him arguing over who was the better vampire count with someone else. And I didn't know anything about the vampire counts at the time. And I'm like, well, I play Chaos, so I wouldn't know. And he looks at me and goes, what day is he? Literally just this whole, I'm like, Nurgle, duh. And he's like, oh, I'm a Khorne player. And we just shook hands and we took off friendship from there. And we would go to the Orcs Den, which is our local gaming group and stuff like that. Hey guys at Orcs Den, how you guys doing? And we just hit it off. And I mean, he ended up becoming my roommate at my apartment and stuff. We did LARP together, which is live action role play. We did LARP together, you name it. He helped me come up with the Grand Thug character, Grand Thug Strongbody. He helped me come up with the Grand Thug character and everything else. And Kenny, man, I have nothing but love for you, brother. Nothing but love, man. I can't wait to hang out again. Madeline, oh my God, Madeline, honey, you're a sweetheart. You really are. Madeline has been a friend of mine since I was 5 years old, 6 years old. I met her through my youngest of my older sisters, Joanne. They used to be the tightest of friends. Okay, I mean, everywhere Madeline was, Joanne was there, and vice versa. Okay, she's like a sister to us, and I love you, Madeline. Love you, Madeline. Liam Dalton, brother. Thank you. Solanja. Seriously. Solanja, brother. Thank you. I know Liam through a modeling group called the Amazing Scale Models. Rosemary, sweetheart. Thank you again. Another friend of the family. My sister Kelly. Thank you, sis. Deborah. Deborah. Now, here in the States, it's called Deborah. In England, we call it Deborah. Thank you, sweetheart. Again, long-time family friend, just got back in contact with her. I remember going out clubbing with her and my sister and whatnot and getting into a lot of shenanigans. Sharon Turner goes, thank you, sweetheart. Again, Bedford, Star Wars D6, she's a sweetheart, love you, darling. My Aunt Rainey, thank you, sweetheart. My mum, guys, I know I give, during my live streams, I have, you know, I say a lot of shit about the troubles between me and my mum. That's between me and my mum. Me and my mum, my therapist, and God, okay? But I'm slowly coming around to patching things up with my mum. And mum, I love you. Thank you. This is probably the only time you're ever gonna see me say these words on video. Mum, I love you, thank you. Caroline, God, Caroline, I haven't seen you in years. I hope your brother's doing good. Last time I saw you, sweetheart, you and Billy were getting ready to go off clubbing, and that's my cousin, Billy. Love you, Caroline, sweetheart. Leah Martin. Thank you, Leah. She's one of my moderators on Twitch, and she lives here, so you can say it to me later. Oh my God, Peter DeWolf. Oh my God, Pete, I haven't seen you in forever, bruv. Hope you're doing good. James Manoso, brother. Much love. Much love to you, man. Thanks for the happy birthday. Kelly, one of my moderators. Kelly Gibson. Thank you, sweetheart.
You're an awesome. My nephew Lee. Lee, thank you, man. Love you too, son. Love you too, brother. Blood Crow. Bro, what the hell, man? That video just cracked me up. Just cracked me up. Brian, dude, your video cracked me up as well, man. Thank you, Brian. Love you too, brother. Love you too. Nothing but love. And Michael. Yes, I know leprechauns laugh when they run because the grass tickles their balls. Thank you, man. And Robert Fud Cannon. Dude, thank you, man. Thank you for all the birthday wishes. My sister Michelle, thank you, sis, for the birthday wishes. I love you too. I love you too. I do. Thank you. And Heath Tompkins. Heath, brother, I'm glad things are working out for you on your end. Stay strong. Be strong. Think positive. Positive things come your way. Okay, guys? Really. I know I just spent 8 minutes thanking a whole bunch of people, you know, who wished me happy birthday. But you know what? Thank you. Thank you to all of you. Seriously. Thanks to all of you. Thank you, Raymond. Bucky, he literally just wished me happy birthday. Thank you, Bucky. Now, like I said, guys, I do have some private messages I want to get to. I'm not going to show those because they're private messages. But again, a big thank you to all of you who've wished me happy birthday. I cannot wait to see you all today on Twitch. Yes, I will be live streaming on my birthday. Just to have some fun, guys, you know? Just to have some fun. I plan on playing a whole bunch of different games like I did yesterday. Probably start off with some World of Tanks and go from there. I'm enjoying my life right now. You know, life could be better, but you know, life can also be worse. So always be grateful for what you've got, because it can be taken away from you in a heartbeat. Okay? In an eye blink and a heartbeat. So remember, guys, love you all. And peace and love, love and respect. Take care, and I'll see you all in the next Coffee Time with Cobra. Okay? Okay. Love you guys. Bye. 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 Bye.